Hi friends, welcome to Markets Guruji. Today we will be discussing about SIS Group, that is Securities and Intelligence Services Company. This is India's second largest security service provider, and in Australia also they are the number one company in the security business. And this company, they have a wide network, that is they have around 251 branches in 125 cities and towns in India, and they cover around 630 districts. And currently they employ around 1,48,678 personnel in India, and in the facilities business they cover around 11,869 customer premises across India. And in Australia they are the number one company in the securities business, and they operate in each of the 8 states in Australia, and they employ around 5,754 personnel, and they service around 245 customers. And this company, they are present in all the segments, all the sectors like banking and finance, IT, telecom, automobile. They provide service to all these sectors. And in the cash logistics business, this company has a nationwide network in India, and they have around 80 branches. And they have around 2,748 cash routes, and it is served by around 2,518 cash vans. And they have around 59 strong rooms. And let us take a broad look about their services. That is, they provide security services, and they are the second largest company in India and the number one company in Australia. And in the cash logistics business, they are the second largest cash logistics service provider in India in terms of market share. And in the electronic securities and service business, they provide surveillance solutions and security solutions and electronic security and all. And in the facility management services, they provide like facilities like cleaning, operations and maintenance. They provide receptionists, lift operators, electricians, plumbers, and they also provide pest control services. And let us take a look at the positives for this particular company. That is, the management is experienced management. They have a diversified portfolio of security services. The business they are into, it has a very huge growth potential. And moreover, they are the leaders in all the businesses that they operate in. And see, this company is a consistent dividend payer, and they have a very wide network of branches across India. And let us take a look about the company's brands, which all brands they own. That is Securities and Intelligence Services, SIS Prosecure, Terminix SIS, Service Master Clean, Tech SIS, and they have a company in Australia that is named as MSS Security. And let us take a detailed analysis of all their businesses. That is their security business in India. The security business in India contribute around 1,587 crore of revenue, Indian rupees, and as a total percentage of revenue, it contributes around 34.68%. And their top 10 customers, they contribute around 22.82%. And for the security business in Australia, it contributes around 2,400 crore Indian rupees, and from that, out of the total revenue, it contributes around 52.32%. And the top 10 customers, they contribute around 42.82% of the total revenue in Australia. And let us take a look at the top players in the security business in India. That is, the number one company in this business is G4 Security Services, and the number two company is Securities and Intelligence Services. You all can take a look at all the companies which are operating in this particular business. And now let us take a look at the cash logistics business. That is, the revenue from this business is around 165 crore. And the revenue from operations as a total percentage is around 3.61%. And the top 10 customers contribute around 79.8% of the total revenue. Let us take a look at the top players in the cash logistics business. That is, the number one company is CMS Info Systems, and the number two company is SIS Prosecure in India, and the number three company is Brinks Aria. You all can take a look at all the companies which are operating in this particular business. And now let us talk about facilities management business. That is, the revenue from the facilities management business is around 386 crore, and as a percentage of total, it is around 8.45%. And see, the number of employees is around 37,371 employees, and they serve around 2,541 customer premises. And the top players in the facilities management business are BVG India. They are the number one player in this particular business. The number two company is ISS Facility Services. Number three is Updater Services. And the number fourth position is with Dusters Total Solutions. and revenue across business segments. See which all business segments contribute how much of revenue. That is, the security business in India contributes around 35%, and the security service business in Australia contribute around 52.32%. The cash logistics business contribute around 3.61%, electronic security around 0.15%, and the facility management business contribute around 8.45%, and the pest control contribute around 0.18%. And you all see, this is one of the top employers, largest employer in India. That is, they employ around 1,54,432 employees. Out of that, see, in India alone, in the security business, they have around 98,000 employees. And in Australia, in the security business, they have around 5,750 employees. And now let us take a look about the industry-wise revenue, which industry sector contributes how much of revenue. That is, the banking and financial services, they contribute around 14.36%, the IT and telecom contribute around 12%, automobile around 8.88%, and steel and heavy industries contribute around 6%. You all can take a whole look how much percentage which all sectors contribute. And let us talk about top 10 shareholders. That is, Ravindra Kishore Sinha, he owns around 41.57% stake. Rita Kishore Sinha owns around 17.63%. Thanyu around 15%. And Rituraj Kishore Sinha around 10.21%. And the total top 10 shareholders, they own around 97.62%. And top selling shareholders, see, Ravindra Kishore Sinha, he is selling around 2.75% out of the total. He owns around 2.85 crore shares, and he is selling around 7,86,000. That is, at around 2.75% of the total he owns. And Rituraj Kishore Sinha, he is selling around 5,24,000 shares out of around 70 lakh he owns. That is, he is selling around 7.47. Thanyu around 32.59. And you all can take a look other shareholders how much they are selling. And let us talk about the objectives of the issue. See, this is for repayment of debt, for working capital requirement, general corporate purpose, and for the listing benefits. And out of that, see, this is from the fresh issue, they will be getting around 362 crore. And out of that, around 200 crore will be for repayment of debt, 60 crore for working capital requirement, and around 102 crore for general corporate purpose. And let us talk about the financials of the company. See, in FY13, the company did a revenue of around 2,657 crore and a net profit of around 57 crore. And the company did a very good growth. That is, in FY17, the revenue was around 4,577 crore and net profit was around 91.3 crore. This company operates in a very, very nice segment. That is, the growth potential for this particular company is very huge. And if you see the EPS for FY17, the EPS is around 13.28 and the PE ratio is around 61.3 and the return on net worth is around 16.85. And currently there is no peer group company which is operating in all the segments, that is, in security services, logistics and facilities management. So we cannot make a comparison for this particular company. And let us talk about the IPO details. See, the IPO is opening on 31st July. The IPO will be closing on 2nd August, and the face value is 10 rupees per share. And the issue price band they have kept is around 805 to 815. And the minimum lot that you have to apply is 18 shares. And for retail allocation, it is 10%. And see, all the details are given, how much offer for sale, how much fresh issue, how much equity shares prior to the offer, after the offer, everything is given here. And see, I would like to tell you that this issue constitutes on, around 13.92%, and the issue size is around 780 crore. And if you see the market cap at around 815, the market cap will be around 6,374 crore. And the listing will be done at NSE and BSE. Hope you all like this video. If you all like this video, do like the video, do subscribe to the channel, and also share this video with your friends and family members. Thank you, friends.